Hello and welcome to episode 20 of Unpacking Articles. The article we're going to unpack today is called The Input-Based Incremental Approach to Vocabulary in Meaning-Oriented Instruction for Language Program Directors and Teachers. And this particular article is actually a chapter in a volume, and it's a very summarized version of this IBI, Input-Based Incremental Approach, that Joe Barcroft has proposed and has written books about. And what he's essentially doing is giving us some principles of effective vocabulary instruction, things that we should keep in mind when we are teaching vocabulary. So let's talk a little bit about what does it mean to know a word. Of course, we need to know properties about its form. How is it spelled? How is it pronounced? And we need to know properties about its meaning. What does it mean? Now, it's not simply knowing the translation, and as we know, some words have multiple translations, but as the author points out, it's about all of the meaning and usage-related properties of a word. That includes where it can appear in a sentence, connotations, what morphosyntactic properties it has, etc. So it is definitely very complex to really know a word. And I think it's also important to point out that it's not just about knowing the properties of a word, but rather how we understand and use the words. As the author points out in this quote, "To be fluent in any language, a learner needs to develop implicit knowledge of the collocational and semantic, including conceptual, properties of any given word or combination of words." That is certainly an ambitious, lofty goal, and we're not going to get there in one lesson, we're not going to get there in one level, and we shouldn't try to get there in one lesson or one level. The author is not saying that we need to do all of this as soon as we introduce a word. Of course not. That's why he proposes an approach that is gradual, incremental. And this approach is called IBI, Input-Based Incremental Vocabulary Instruction. I'm going to simplify, summarize, synthesize the 10 principles so that you can get the gist of it. And the first principle is about being intentional in how we teach vocabulary and what words we target. And we need to decide which words to target based on the communicative task that we want students to be able to accomplish. And while the author insists on the importance of having a plan on deciding which words to target and being very intentional about how we present those words, what I like about this approach is that it makes it clear that intentional vocab learning doesn't mean learning isolated words and then figuring out something to do with them. The words are still subservient to communication. And we are presenting them in context, we are using them in context, and so there's still a lot of room for incidental learning. And perhaps unsurprisingly, many of the principles of this approach revolve around input and the type of input that we should provide to present the words. And one of them is that even though we're targeting certain words, that doesn't mean that we're presenting them isolated, going back to what I just said. We provide them in contextualized, comprehensible, and purposeful input. The students are doing something with the input. So if we tell them, for example, what types of clothes we usually wear, then we embed questions as we talk with the students to see if the students also wear that, if they like it better, which one they prefer, etc. And so we are not only making it more interactive and helping the learners pay attention to these words, but also we can repeat and recycle these words throughout the input that we're giving them. And that's another requirement. You need to present the words multiple times and in multiple ways or in enhanced ways. One of the suggestions the author gives is perhaps to sometimes say the words slower and sometimes a little bit faster, pronouncing them slightly different each time to sort of call the student's attention to that word. In terms of how many words, the author doesn't give us a magic number, but you need to make sure that these words you're targeting appear multiple times, because we know frequency is good, and also in multiple ways. Pronouncing them differently, faster, slower, having them written down, having them only oral. So if we want learners to have multiple encounters and engagement with these words, we certainly won't be able to target a lot of words. Okay, so far we talked about what to do, right, to provide this input, but what about what to avoid within this approach? Based on research findings, these are the main two things to avoid. And the first one has to do with the incremental part of the name of this approach. And it refers to not rushing in terms of complexity of the tasks that we are asking them to do with these new words. We cannot go from here are the words to one matching activity to all of a sudden use these words to write sentences or to write a paragraph. That is too much too fast. And the other principle that I think is important to keep in mind also is to avoid meaningless forced output in early stages. Now, the author doesn't say a whole lot about later stages or whether there are any benefits to meaningless forced output, but at the very least, he is very, very clear that meaningless forced output, for example, choral repetition or simply copying words, could actually be detrimental to learning the words, to knowing the words. And this comes from evidence of studies that show that when the learners are first exposed to the words, when they're first learning, what does this word mean? And they are asked to copy the words, to write them down or just to repeat them. And then we ask them, what does the word mean? Do you remember what the word means? They perform worse than students who didn't have to copy the words. And it makes sense, right? Because the students who were asked to copy the words probably were so concerned about copying the words that they were not paying any attention to the meaning. So they were less likely to remember what the word meant later on. I do want to clarify that meaningless forced output is not the same as retrieval. Retrieval, in the sense of producing the word in a meaningful context, is actually very good, and nobody is disputing that. What he's talking about with meaningless forced output are things that you can do without paying any attention to the word's meaning. Toward the end of the article, the author provides a series of questions to help teachers and program directors reflect on their approach to vocabulary instruction. And some of those questions are, in what ways are target words presented in the input? How frequently and repeatedly are target words presented? Are the vocabulary-related activities incremental in nature? Do they provide learners with opportunity to acquire multiple meanings and uses of target words? So let's talk a little bit about these questions. The first one, I want you to notice the ways, plural, right? Ways that are presented in the input. So not just one and done, not just picture, word, move on to the next slide. How frequently and repeatedly are the target words presented? That's something that I personally sometimes struggle with because I am not intentional enough about repeating or recycling those words. And the vocabulary activities need to be incremental in nature. That last question about acquiring multiple meanings and uses of target words is fantastic, but incrementally, in the long run, do we give students opportunities to acquire multiple meanings and uses of target words? But you don't have to do it all in one unit. You don't have to do it all in one level. And so the takeaway for me involves these three adjectives that describe this approach, but I think that they're also applicable to so many other aspects of language teaching. Intentional, incidental, incremental. We need to be intentional about our goal and how we're going to get there, but we also need to embrace incidental learning, all of the learning that we did not plan. And of course, we need to understand that it's going to be a long road. We cannot rush from point A to point B. That's just my take on it. As usual, I encourage you to read the original and draw your own conclusions. Thank you for tuning in, and until next time.